Think that you can only absorb 20 grams of protein at a time? That you need to eat protein every 2 hours? Or that a high protein diet is bad for your kidneys? These myths have been floating around gyms for years, and today we're busting them with science. Let's dive in. People often say that you can only absorb or use 20 grams of protein at a time. Is this true? This idea is based on a somewhat flawed 2014 study that showed consuming 20 grams of whey protein after a workout maximized muscle protein synthesis, and that increasing that dose to 40 grams of whey protein did not increase muscle protein synthesis any more than the 20 grams did. This study also only measured muscle protein synthesis for 4 hours after the ingestion of the protein. Another thing that doesn't make sense is that it's well established that it requires 3 grams of leucine to adequately stimulate muscle protein synthesis, yet 20 grams of whey protein only provides about 2 grams of leucine. A more recent study published in 2023 sets the record straight. The researchers found that when they measured muscle protein synthesis for the 12 hours following a meal that provided either 25 grams of protein or following a meal that provided 100 grams of protein, the meal providing 100 grams of protein increased muscle protein synthesis significantly greater than the 25 gram meal did, particularly during the last 8 hours of the 12-hour period. So don't worry about an upper limit to protein intake per meal. Shoot for a minimum of 30 grams of protein per meal, and if you eat more than that, it won't go to waste. Protein is broken down to amino acids in the body that are used for way more than just repair and building muscle, like hormone synthesis, tissue repair, and even energy production. The idea that you can't absorb or use more than 20 grams of protein is just bad science. It's not about maximum protein per meal, it's about hitting your daily protein target. Ever heard you need to eat protein every 2 hours or your muscles will disappear? Let's talk about it. Here's the deal. Protein timing can help, but it's not life or death. Based on the current research, it appears eating enough quality protein each day is more important for muscle growth than when you eat it. Those wanting to build muscle should shoot for 0.7 to 0.9 grams of protein per pound of body weight. But an easy way to calculate this is to eat 1 gram of protein for every pound that you weigh. So a 180 pound person should shoot for around 180 grams of protein per day. It may also be best to evenly distribute your protein intake over all daily meals. One study found that in 2 groups of men, consuming the same total amount of protein each day while following a 12-week weight training program, the men who ate around 30 grams of protein at breakfast, at lunch, and at dinner gained about 40% more lean muscle mass than men eating a low protein breakfast of around 10 grams of protein, a moderate protein lunch of around 30 grams, and a high protein dinner of around 60 grams of protein. This is likely due to the fact that the low protein breakfast, providing only 10 grams of protein, was insufficient to boost muscle protein synthesis, which is how muscles grow. Research suggests that it requires around 3 grams of the amino acid leucine to adequately stimulate muscle protein synthesis. Most protein sources require at least 30 grams to provide those 3 grams of leucine. So the men eating the low protein breakfast had only 2 opportunities each day to stimulate muscle protein synthesis, while the men eating adequate protein at all 3 meals had 3 opportunities to boost muscle protein synthesis, resulting in their better gains. So instead of worrying about eating protein every so many hours, simply divide your daily protein requirement evenly among all your daily meals. If your daily protein requirement is 180 grams of protein and you eat breakfast, lunch, dinner, and a snack around your workout, that's 4 meals evenly divided into about 45 grams of protein at each meal. Consistency matters more than eating every 2 hours. Aim for balanced meals, not panic meals. Is your workout wasted if you don't slam a protein shake immediately after training? Let's bust that. The anabolic window is real, but it's not that short. If you train fasted, then it's a good idea to eat immediately after the workout to prevent muscle breakdown. But if you ate before you trained, then you still have nutrients in your system. In fact, research shows that the anabolic window stays open for several hours, and in some cases, even up to a full day in beginners. Experienced lifters have a shorter window, but it's still open for several hours after the workout is over. I prefer to eat protein and carbs as soon as possible after a workout is over for two reasons. The first, you simply feel better when you refuel after a grueling workout that depleted your body. So why prolong feeling better? And second, eating a meal as soon as possible after your workout is over allows you to fit in more meals each day and therefore fit in more spikes and muscle protein synthesis than if you waited several hours after the workout was over to have your next meal. Post-workout nutrition matters, but don't panic if you can't chug a shake the minute you rack the weights. Some people think protein isn't an energy source, and they're wrong. When your body breaks down protein into amino acids, they do more than just build muscle. They can also fuel you. And that's especially true of the branched chain amino acids, leucine, isoleucine, and valine, which can be directly used by the muscles as an energy source. During intense training, the body uses carbs first, but protein is always in the mix. And the lower your carb intake, the more important those amino acids are as fuel. In fact, high protein diets have been found to improve endurance and reduce fatigue. There are no essential carbs, but essential amino acids exist. That should tell you just how important protein is. Protein isn't just for gains, it also helps to keep your energy up. Want to lose fat? Cutting protein is the worst move you can make. Protein actually boosts fat loss. Why? It keeps you full, reduces hunger, increases calorie burn through digestion, and preserves muscle while you drop body fat. In one study, those eating more protein, despite eating 500 more calories per day, lost more body fat than those eating less. More food, more protein, more fat loss? Crazy, right? Protein isn't the enemy of fat loss. It's your secret weapon. Think milk and cheese make you fat? Science says the opposite. Dairy has fat, but it also has the most anabolic proteins you can eat. Studies show that dairy consumption is associated with a leaner body composition, not fat gain. Plus, saturated fat in moderation helps with hormone health. So instead of avoiding dairy, use it to build muscle while dropping body fat. Dairy protein isn't the enemy. It's one of your best tools for lean gains. Is chicken better than a protein shake? Not always. Protein powders are food. They come from milk or eggs or plants like peas and rice. In some cases, powders are better, especially around workouts, because they digest easier and faster to deliver their amino acids to your muscles quicker. A blend of whey protein and casein protein is best, as they provide both fast and slow digesting proteins to boost muscle protein synthesis higher and for longer. Protein powders are just another form of food, not a shortcut. Whole food matters, but protein powders can be just as good or even better at the right time. Is eating too much protein bad for your kidneys? Let's settle this. This is one of the oldest myths around. In people with healthy kidneys, study after study shows high protein diets are perfectly safe. The kidney scare comes from research in people with existing kidney disease, not in healthy athletes. In fact, one 2024 study not only found no correlation between higher protein diets and chronic kidney disease, but they also reported that higher protein diets may reduce the risk of chronic kidney disease by 20%. Higher protein diets are also linked to better body composition and health markers. Unless you already have existing kidney issues, there is no evidence that protein is dangerous. High protein diets aren't just safe, they're better for building muscle, losing fat, and staying healthy. So there you have it, 8 of the most common protein myths busted. Protein isn't the enemy. It's the foundation for muscle, energy, fat loss, and health. Comment with your favorite protein myth and share this video with someone who needs it. Stick with the science. Follow for more no BS nutrition advice and train hard.